guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ritika and today we are going to dive into the fundamental world of AWS IAM, Identity Access Management. So in this video, what we are going to discuss is about the basics of IAM and we'll see how we'll create IAM users, groups and roles. So if you are interested, stay tuned till the end and let's get started. So the first is, what is IAM?
To host an application in the cloud, you need to secure your access management through AWS IAM. AWS IAM helps you to protect your AWS resources by allowing you to control who can access and what action they can perform. With the principle of least privilege, you can define specific permissions for users, groups, and roles, and you can assign temporary access. With the centralized management, you can fine-grained permission and grant right access to the right people at the right time.
The outside users are integrated to your company through Microsoft Active Directory or the third-party identity provider like Facebook and Google. Authenticated users can then assume roles in AWS to perform the task. It can be accessed through AWS CLI, AWS Management Console, and AWS SDKs and API calls. So we get the brief understanding of what is AWS IAM and Identity Access Management. For IAM users, authentication must be done in terms of using the AWS resources. So first they need to log in through their root account. But what is root account? Root account is just your email ID through which you will be initially signing up to the AWS Management Console. The root account is having the full administrative access to the AWS resources. So if you lose the root account or if someone gains the access to your root account, it can be easily tampered. And so we need to secure the root account and we need to keep it in safe. So let's go and see how we'll create the root account. If you have seen my previous video on AWS EC2, I have logged in my AWS account through root user. Let's go and see it.
Yeah guys, so we have logged in our root account with our email ID and password, and now we are in the console. So now we'll search the IAM. So in services, we will go on security, identity and compliance. And we'll click on IAM, or we can directly go on the search bar and type IAM, and yes, we get that, and we'll go to the IAM. Okay, so now we are on the dashboard, IAM dashboard. So as you can see here, I am getting an error as add MFA for root user. So we'll click on add MFA now and we'll go to the screen. Can see here we have now we can select the MFA device, whichever device you feel like, authenticator, app, security key, hardware, TOTP. So we'll click on next and then we'll go on setup device, and here you can see you have options. You can use Google Authenticator, Duo Mobile or Auth app, whichever you feel like. You can just download it on your mobile or your computer, and you can even click on the see a list of compatible applications. You can see whichever you feel like, you can download it on your mobile and or your computer, and once it's done you will get this show. Click on show QR code and you will scan it on your authenticator app, and then you will get, you need to put the two MFA code, MFA 1 and 2, and then you can click on add MFA. So now you are on my security credentials and your MFA is added to your account. So next time when you log in to your AWS account, you need to put the MFA code and you will get into that account.
So once you create your root account and when you enable your MFA to your root account, then we'll create an admin group and we'll assign the IAM users to that admin group, so that we can apply the permission policies. So now we can create the admin group, and in that admin group we can add users to it and we can assign reasonable permissions to access the AWS. As in your organization, you have different departments, so you can create your groups according to your departments and assign permissions to those groups, and then you can add the users to those groups. So it will be easy for you to maintain and manage your IAM users. Each user in the group will be provisioned with the same permission policies. If the IAM user got authenticated, it doesn't mean that the user can access to the AWS resources because they need to be authorized for those resources. So by default, IAM users are access denied. So for that, we need to grant permissions to perform their task. IAM users will be assigned to the IAM policies. So what is IAM policies? IAM policies is just a JSON document which will be attached to the group, what users can do in the AWS or which API calls they can invoke. Any action by default is denied unless it is explicitly allowed to that user. Let's take a look to the sample policy, and we'll open the IAM read access policy. Or read only access policy is the just the example I have taken over here. So as you can see, it's a JSON script, and in this the version is mentioned, and in statement it says effect allow. In action it will be mentioned like what the user is allowed in the IAM. Generate credential reports, generate service list. Service last access details can get command, list command, and stimulate custom policies, stimulate principal policies, and are the actions which are allowed in this script. And resource, it can be any resource. Asterisk means the all the resources. Read-only access will be given to that user to all the resources. If we've mentioned EC2 or S3, whatever the resource which we want given access to, we can mention it over here. And if the asterisk is there, it means all the resources are allowed for read-only in this script. So that was the sample IAM policies. And in AWS console, we have hundreds of IAM policies. But if you want a custom policy, you can create your custom policy according to your organization needs. So let's go to roles. What are roles? IAM roles are identical to IAM users. IAM users, applications, and services may assume IAM role. There is no access key or credential attached to that IAM role. IAM users, one assigned IAM role, it will take down the user's permissions and will give the IAM role permissions to that account temporarily. And once the task is done, it will be taken down and the user's permissions will be resumed. So it's like wearing different hats for different tasks. So till now, we have learned that how we can manage IAM users with and their access. What are IAM roles and how to manage those, and manage federation users and their permissions. But remember, the journey is not end over here. The AWS IAM is a vast topic with numerous advanced features, use cases. If you find this introduction helpful, want to continue with the AWS IAM, please subscribe to my channel and get updated on AWS topics. And if you found value in this video, please don't forget to click on thumbs up, share it with your friends. And if you have any specific questions which you want me to cover it in future videos, put that on the comments below in the comment section. I'll definitely read those. And if you want to know what is AWS EC2, go and check out this link. Thank you so much for joining here. Your engagement and support is what keeps this channel going. Until next time, keep innovating, keep learning, and keep securing your AWS resources with IAM. This is Ritika Verma signing off. See you in next video. Bye-bye.